Assalamu alaikum and welcome to Jan Sewing Solutions. I'm going to share my finished results with you for these suits that I designed for a friend of mine who is going to receive her honours, which is called an MBE. And someone asked, what is an MBE? It's a special award. It's a special award given by the Queen to people who have done extraordinary good work for the community. Okay, so mashallah, this is one of my friends who is getting this reward, and it's always a privilege for an Asian to get this reward. Obviously, us Asians do have a bit for the community as well, and sometimes it doesn't get recognized. So mashallah, congratulations to her for being honored for her work for the community. So I was privileged to make the suits for her. I've done her two outfits so she can choose which one she wants to wear. She's gone for, well, actually I went with her to choose the colors. We went for this these subtle looks and beautiful fabric that is from Oak Mound Mill. It's a woolen mix and it drapes and hangs absolutely beautiful. So she is about a size 16, although she's dropped quite a bit of weight. Anyway, I'm just going to explain what I've done to these suits. They are plain suits, so I've added my personal touches to them. This one I have added a pearl neckline. These are one of the ready-made necklines, and I used Wonder Web to glue this onto place. I stitched around the neckline portion of it and also added these pearl edging to the front of the sleeves. And then for the hemline, I had this dory type of piping in a bit of a little bit of a shimmery type of edging, and it's given it a beautiful finish. Now, one of the things that I want to point out is on suits like this, to get that specialized personal touch, and that, you know, don't go for the machine turnings, do hand darbai, and that will give it a real personalized, intricate, sort of like a delicate touch to it. So all darbai done all the way. It is time consuming and it's a little bit tedious, but it's worthwhile doing hand darbai. And this is a very classic suit, so classy suit needs to have a personalized touch. A very nice drapey fabric again, and a beautiful look to it. This is like a rich butter gold creamy color. Okay, and what I've done is I have done a straight trouser. Now, you've seen me do the cutting on the trousers. The only thing I did was it looked slightly larger than the size that I required. So what I did was I actually took it in about half an inch more than what I, you know, I took like about an inch and a quarter from all sides. And that way it sort of like give it more of a fitted look. I tried one of these on yesterday and I asked her how does it feel, and she says, you know what, you don't even feel like you're wearing a trouser. Now, one of the problems with Asian trousers is they tend to do a very lengthy crutch, and a simple explanation of that is yesterday she bought this for her own daughter, a ready-made suit, and she said, my daughter's worn it and she says it's very uncomfortable. And when I measured, the front crotch and the back crotch were equal length and they were really, really lengthy. The inside leg was just that much and the crotch was that much. Sort of 3/4 of the length of the trouser was just a crotch, and it just made it uncomfortable. Now, I had to take it apart and add in pieces there, and I had to cut the length of the crotch down from the front and put an extension in at the back. So now that's the front crotch and that's the back crutch, and you do need it longer at the back. So that's just an example of the Asian tailoring of trousers for you. Now, with this one, that's your front crutch, and then and that's the back crutch. You can see how much deeper that is and how much lengthier it is as well. And really, that's, you know, If you look at that, there is about 4 or 5 inch difference between the front and the back, and that's what makes it comfortable. If it's too long at the front, it tends to, you know, distort the shape of the inside leg. And so that's the, now I've done the same cut on both these trousers, but mashallah, I hope that she has the time to try this on, and I can just take a couple of photos and post those onto my Facebook page so you can see just what a wonderful outfit this is. Okay, so with these outfits, what we did was we designed a jacket. I'll try and place all this like this so you can get a sort of a viewing of what this suit ends up looking like. The other suit that we've done is like more of a pinky hint of like a pinky hint to it. Okay, and now this is the jacket. Initially when I made the jacket, it was a little bit wide, so I've tapered it in and I've shaped it. It's just a very straightforward type of a jacket. I've just done a little bit of a detailing with lace in a rose gold. And again, I've shaped this, and now that this looks far, far more shaped and elegant look to it as well. Okay, there we are. As you can see, just the look of the jacket, you can see that it has like a flow and it has a shape. So that's the sort of complete look of the suit. That suit one with the jacket. Now the other one, I'm going to leave the jacket where it is and I'm going to show you the other one. And there's a lot of detailing on this one that I've done. What you saw me was doing the cutout of this from the net. I chose the lighter color and I arranged it in such a way to get a very detailed neckline done out of the lace. I also used the same lace and applied it on the hem, and I also used the same lace and applied it on the sleeves. Now the dress was coming out a marginally shorter, longer than the jacket, and which it didn't look right. So what I did was, prior to doing the side turnings, which are the jacks, I did these small four pleats, and that shortened the dress and made it go beautifully with the jacket. Okay, so it's a double combination. Let's place this inside and give you a view of what this one looks like. And the good thing about these fabrics is that they don't have static, so the trouser will hang absolutely beautifully. Generally with Asian type of fabrics, they don't, you know, always the trousers tend to cling to your legs because there's normally a lot of static in them. Now that's outfit number two. This is the trouser with it, same version of the trouser. Just give you a color, a slight bit of a color difference, which is, this is more of like a pinky. And she's got a matching headscarf in this color. She's also got a matching handbag and shoes, this more of the darker color, and it's an absolutely amazingly beautiful suit. Anyway, I hope that has given you some ideas. There you are, that's a little bit of a closer up of, you know, she's not going to fasten the jacket, it's going to be like an open jacket, but it sort of gives you an idea of whichever suit she wears. That's look one, and if I place the other one, that will give you a look two. And there's also a look three that I wanted to design for her, but being restricted on time, I didn't get a chance to do the third one. And if she wants to treasure this jacket, then I will perhaps in the future do a design three for her as well. I'm going to place this inside as well, just give you a hint of what this looks like. And if you want to see the photos of these, what I'll do is I will place these on the mannequin and take photos and put them on Facebook. I'll put the link at the bottom of the video so you can see. It's trying to muddle everything in at the same time. There you are, that's with the pearl necklines. Who needs jewellery when you've got beautiful necklines like this? There you are. How good does that look? Absolutely amazing. I'm well pleased, well chuffed with the result. I hope she likes the result just as much as I've enjoyed making this. I love the challenge of designing something new. And it's been hectic couple of weeks because I was away in Pakistan for a couple of weeks due to an emergency. I will probably fill you in on that in the next video. For the time being, I'm gonna love you and leave you, and do give the video a thumbs up if you like the outfit. You've seen how I went about cutting this outfit. Now stitching it, do you know what? It's just, you just have to be a little bit extra careful when you stitch stuff like this and pay attention to little details, like I mentioned, doing the chalks and so on. Now, with the patches that I took off of the net, you know what? It's a great and beautiful idea. What I did was ironed on Wonder Web, and I went around with my machine and you know, around all the edges, which it has fixed absolutely perfectly. This will last a lifetime, you know, just as the fabric is a hard wearing fabric, so is the embroidery. I don't think we're going to have any problem with this fraying or going away. It's a beautiful lace and amazing what you can achieve. I mean, if you went out and bought an outfit like this, you know, you could end up paying a considerable amount of money, because it's the fabric itself is a quality fabric that you've chosen and taken time out. You choose to add on what you like, you get it stitched in your own size. So any ready-made garment, I'm sorry, but there's absolutely no comparison. And the best advice I would offer to all my viewers is take that extra time and make the one-off unique garments like these and wear them with pride. Because you know what, you can go around and buy 10, 12, 15 pound suits ready-made, but they are, you know, you wear them the once and you do not want to wear them the second time. And that's a fact. I mean, I personally do not go out and buy ready-mades. I go and buy the fabric, and when I get time, I'll stitch them. But family members who have gone out and bought these, sometimes they don't even end up wearing them. You know, they are fascinated initially and will go out and buy something off the peg. And then as soon as they bought it home, you know what, the appeal has gone. So when you put the effort in yourself, you're sort of like, you know what, I put my heart into this, I'm going to wear it. So that's the advice that I would give you. Anyway, take care, and I will join you again soon.